Hey, buddy. Anthony Dodge, Model Train Outsider, American Outsider, back with the second of these two Toy Museum videos. In this video, I'm going to be showing you what I filmed at Hans-Peter Porsche's Traumwerk. Now, Traumwerk is not just the Model Train exhibit that we showed you in a previous video while we were in Germany. It is also a toy museum, and it highlights his personal toy collection along with everything else. In fact, the building has several sections. One section is actually some of his favorite personal Porsche automobiles. And then there is a exhibition wing where they have different themes twice a year, once a year, over a couple of year period. For example, they were recently celebrating the circus, so they had an exhibition of circus-based toys, as well as things from an actual circus. We did not film a lot of that. My wife Joyce took a lot of pictures, but my camera was, the batteries were dying, even though I had a spare charger. Sometimes when you're filming in 4K with my phone, the phone drains very quickly and the battery can't keep up with it. So anyhow, I hope you...
All right, we have reached the Porsche Museum. So where do you start? You know, you got the history of the cars here. Targa. If you want a operating RC version of that car, you can get it for 95 euros. '964 Turbo S. And the 911T. Now, mind you, '356 Cabrio. Yeah, belonging to Hans Haas. Built in 1927. And then some model trains. If you want to buy them, they give you the price. There's a 218 for 1,300 euros. You can buy this entire model train for 1,300. You all right? Watch the wire behind you. In the car for 90 euros each. And you can get these little models for 180 euros. Another yacht model. We are in Hans-Peter Porsche's tin toy collection. This is obviously when you have Porsche money, you can buy everything else. Some of this is actually Märklin. Yep, number three is specifically from Märklin. That's from Märklin right there. All kinds of tin soldiers and the thing I always found in the old days where these tins were very thin. You may have seen those in America, and some of them actually came in we saw in tobacco packages. You could get figures, little wooden carved ones too. A bit of cards. It would take forever to try to film all of this. This little toy train. So I'm just gonna give sort of a sorry, honey. Little school set. Little sewing machines. Thank you. should do is make those tiered. Miniature birds. Little baby dolls in. I will say they make these ones on the bottom rows very hard to see. Oh, now here we go. That's what my stuff is, get castles and knights. Russian flag. And of course, blocks. Very, very local, Anka, because that's where we are. Actually, we're in Anka, but this is from Märklin as well. Märklin Kreisenspiel. I lost choice. Building a magic lantern. They're setting up a circus here, so there's going to be a little circus outside. But just toys to toys to toys all over. And set up in very cool themes. Again, little models of men working, women working. Thank you. drinking his beer, eating his sausage. Dumping his beer on himself. The painter. The miner. Exercising. These are called Dampfmaschinen, Betriebsmodels. Machine models, and could be operated. Dampf is steam. That next window, again, just more steam machines. I believe they said that one is Märklin. Oh, that one they do operate. Oh, okay. That's the first one I've seen that has an operation button. Toys well over. Printing press model. That apparently actually did print things up. Amazing. And again, just more steam engines, steam motors. And here is a Märklin 1947 Crocodile. So that's from 1947. And then the train in front of it's from the 50s. Oh, wait, no, I'm sorry. That's the 1947 Crocodile. And that's a tin crocodile from 1900. Then the long train here behind with a crocodile, articulated crocodile, is from the 1950s. So this bigger crocodile, which I assume is O. I believe they're saying is a Dietmar crocodile. There, now we'll get some good detail on it. Ernst Planck. And you got the money. Toys. And their toys. So here is a clockwork. Doesn't say who manufactured it though. up, it's Charles Rossignol from Paris. So that was a French one. So these were French models. Charles Maltesia. So you got two French and German. Keep this under relatively soft lighting to protect the finish on the toys. There really is so much to show here. It just keeps going and going. And this is an American style train. It's a Western. It's a US president train. With an entire cowboy and western theme. You got the buffalo, you got cowboys and US soldiers, obviously not necessarily great. You got cowboys and Indians fighting. I'm just, I could be here forever if I tried to give you all details. The best thing to do is put this on as big a TV as you got and maybe even pause the screen at times. I'm filming in 4K. And then y'all can just check out some of the detail. It'll be a little cheaper than coming here. And we have a toy train that was designed to crash. We have this whole toy set here where one train is crashed and dumped and the other train can pick it up and you can put it back together again. How wild is that? This is one of the first producers of what became known as TT tabletop. This is a Tischbahn, a table or desk train by Bing, and I believe they technically were the inventors of tabletop, although a couple of companies argue over who did it, but most sources I've said say it's Bing. So this is a little bigger than N scale and smaller than HO kind. It's right in the middle. You can see it's three rail. Get a bit of a sky view and come on down. And then if you really have the space and want to show off your layout, believe it or not, my camera says it is already filling up. And I haven't even gone to the main train display. So, for you guys, I'm going to do a couple of just quick panoramas, because this goes on and on. There's just so many old toy trains here. This one's got the little man flying over, so we'll come this way. And again, I'm sure there's some patience, but I only have so much video time. I really planned on doing a quick walkthrough here, and I've stayed and filmed more than I planned. This is a Merklin set. And again, the best thing you can do is just pause and zoom in, because this just goes on and on. And on, and on. So you can see the room keeps going. A lot of Merklin here. Miles of different stations around the world. Little castle on top. Merklin again. And see, even every pillar has a cool little display in it, so this is really impressive. I got these little ones here. Say they make it hard. You can see on the other side this little rail car. See if I can get in there close. And there's this one. Nice working clock inside the station. Friedrichshafen Bahnhof. Different model versions of it. if you think you've come around. That's how much further to go with the toy collection. It's insane. So now we're into the tin Mickey Mouse stuff. There's a whole cave through here. Little kitty play area with wooden blocks and trains. And again, just every window filled. Can't do this place justice. You'd have to do a 2-hour documentary. Little traffic scene. All the toy automobiles here. Over there. Policeman arresting a man. Even the little action figures, the dolls. And this is Merklin. Let's see. Emperor Franz Josef with Friedrich des Weite. Or Wilhelm des Weite, excuse me. Scenes. Cannons. Military. Yes, even World War II military. And then, we get this monster. Das ist Bad dafür. Yeah. Mm-hmm. All right, and this is the last thing I'm going to film are the ships here, because already I am well below 50 minutes available, and I haven't even gone to the layout yet. I'm not going to bother with this circus. This is a temporary. But I'm just gonna go through these boats real fast. And you got a whole circus toy display. The Krona Circus is here. And so they're doing a special display just for it. And then 75 years of Porsche. Submarines and space toys. I can understand, man. I was a toy collector and I finally stopped and sold off most of my collections. And then I saved this model for last. This is the Crown Princess and Cecile. Look at this model. All the lights on it. This section and video done.
Okay, well, there was our other half of the Traumwerk. We already showed you the model train in a 4K video a couple of weeks ago while we were in Germany, and now here's the other part. I hope, even if you're just a model train guy, that you might find those toys interesting. I know I found his model ships area extremely interesting. He had a lot of cool model ships there. Alright, so until whatever video I post next, I'm going to say auf Wiedersehen, tschüss, and happy trains. Take care, everybody.